So I was talking to a student and I was trying to explain how to do this. And then I thought, why don't I just send him a video? Then I thought, I don't think I've really created a video like this before. So many times we will want to put a fabric texture or pattern into a flat sketch. And the easiest way to do that is to create a pattern swatch. But if you don't have a true repeat, it can come out all types of wrong. So the next best thing is to mask it. And for many of us, this is the best option, particularly if you are working with a small pattern swatch or a picture of something.
The technique we're going to use for both Photoshop and Illustrator is called masking. So let's start with how to do this in Photoshop. Now in Photoshop, there's three kinds of masks, but the one that is probably the simplest and the one I'm going to demo is a layer mask. So let's say we want to put this plaid into this sketch. First, copy and paste the texture you want to place into your selection. Make sure the texture is bigger than the area it needs to fill, and keep in mind you can always scale it up or down later. As soon as you paste this new texture onto your page, it will automatically create a new layer. So hide the layer so you can see the sketch. Switch to the layer with the sketch, and make a selection of the area you want the texture to go into. And there are several different ways you can do this, but I'm going to use the Quick Selection tool. Once you've made your selection, switch back to the layer with the texture, turn it back on, and while the selection of the sketch is still highlighted, create the layer mask. Press the Add Layer Mask icon at the bottom of the Layers panel, or as one of my students likes to say, hit the button. Once you create your layer mask, you'll notice that the layer now has two thumbnails, one with the texture and the other that's just black and white, which represents the selection. And between them is a chain link, which keeps the texture and the selection together so they function as one, not two separate items. If you want to modify the graphic, say you want to make it smaller, click the chain link to unlink them and then click on the thumbnail with the graphic. This will allow you to modify the plaid without changing the selection. I usually use Free Transform, which is in the Edit menu, to modify an object. So I'm going to use that to scale this down. The shortcut is Command or Control T, which will place a box around the texture, similar to the bounding box in Illustrator. Then, drag any corner to scale down the texture, and note that you no longer need to hold the Shift key to keep the object proportional, which you used to have to do in previous versions of Photoshop. Once you're done scaling, press the Enter or Return key on your keyboard to make the new dimensions take effect. Lastly, be sure to click again in the same area to relink the two thumbnails so they again operate as one item. In Illustrator, you start out similarly, pasting the texture and making sure it's bigger than the area it needs to go into. There are two ways to do masks in Illustrator, using the traditional clipping mask function or using a newer function called draw inside. I'm going to use the newer draw inside function. To use draw inside, position the texture where it should go and then cut it. Then select the closed shape it's going into. And sidebar, you do need to make sure it's a closed shape. Select the draw inside mode and then go to Edit, Paste in Place. The texture should now be inside the shape and you can switch back to draw normal mode.
I have successfully used both techniques in many of my projects, particularly since a lot of my clients don't have large swatches of their fabrics, and with the small swatch that they give me, I really can't make a believable pattern swatch. Now, if you have decided that you are going to do this in Illustrator and you're not familiar with draw inside, you can check out this video to learn more about it. And if you have used clipping masks in the past in Illustrator, you'll find that draw inside is a similar method, but in my opinion, it's easier. But either method that you choose, clipping masks or draw inside, you'll get the result that you're looking for. Thanks for watching today's tutorial. If you are new to digital fashion design, make sure you check out the links in the description for more information about my classes in Illustrator and Photoshop for Fashion, as well as to get some great freebies. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this if you found it helpful. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.